Hi, I'm Sonika. I'm a media professional and I'm also the mother of a three-year-old boy. We have been leading a low-waste and a sustainable lifestyle for a few years now. And I'm here to tell you why we do it and share some tips with you so that you can also bring up your child in a sustainable manner. Well, we weren't always leading this kind of a lifestyle. I think this realization just set in once we had our son, Abir. And we realized that our lifestyle was leading to a lot of unnecessary waste and was really harming the planet and hence our son's future. So we decided that we would do whatever we could to contribute to the solution and not to the problem, and become more sustainable, generate lesser waste and do whatever we could to make this, you know, future brighter for the next generation. Tip number one, less is more. I think as parents, we generally tend to go a little overboard buying things for our kids, be it clothes, shoes, toys, books, etc. We've been very conscious of that, and we are also very lucky that we have had friends who have had kids just before our son, so we got a lot of hand-me-downs. If you have friends or family who have older kids, take their stuff, use it. Most of the time, you can, you know, it still has life and you can still pass it on. That's what we've been doing with another friend of ours who has a younger kid. We pass on my son's stuff to them. And if you don't have anyone to take things from, there are a lot of resources on Facebook and Instagram where you can actually buy pre-loved things from. So not only does it save money, but it also really is a huge contribution to not generating too much extra waste. So tip number two, try and celebrate festivals and occasions like birthdays or Diwali or Christmas in a sustainable and a low waste manner. And I think the one of the biggest sources of waste coming out from these festivals is disposables. Disposable plates, cutlery, napkins and things like that. All you have to do is use what you already have at home, your existing crockery and cutlery. And if you're doing something with kids like a birthday party, you can invest once in a set of, let's say, steel crockery and cutlery, which you can use for years and you can keep reusing it for other occasions as well. So for my son's first birthday, we actually had a zero waste theme, and we decided that we are not going to use anything that's disposable, including the decor. So we got cloth buntings, which were made of fabric waste that we had. We had the fabric lying at home. Tip number three. Encourage outdoor play. I know that it may sound very obvious, but this is something that can really inculcate a sense of awareness and environment in your kid. My son actually goes down to play for 3 to 4 hours every day. He goes in the morning for 2 hours and then again in the evening for about 1.5 to 2 hours. And it is not just playing, he's also made friends with our building gardeners and they let him do a lot of their work, which is so amazing because he really understands so much more about plants and about the environment. He digs his hand in the dirt, he picks up snails and earthworms, he's not scared of them. And I think he's really, really close to nature. So my next tip is to involve your kids. We've actually been involving our son in all kinds of household activities and chores so that this kind of a lifestyle comes naturally to him, and we make it a lot of fun for him. So this is, you know, it doesn't seem like a chore, but it seems like something that he's having fun with, something he's involved in, and I think it gives him a sense of accomplishment and also a sense of belonging. So he doesn't do anything differently. He does what we do and we all live the same kind of a lifestyle. So if we segregate our waste, he knows about waste segregation. If I compost every day, he actually knows about composting and he's been helping me out with it for a really, really long time. He's not even three and he's now reached a stage where he puts all the wet waste in the composter and he knows what composting is all about. He knows that the wet waste turns into black soil. So he knows that process. My next tip is that for your kids, try and use sustainable products, be it food, be it personal care, be it toys, be it clothes. And there are a lot of amazing Indian sustainable brands that actually have products across all of these categories.
I'll show you some of the products that we use for him. We use his natural soap, it's a really cute one. This is a bamboo toothbrush and he has never used a plastic toothbrush. have this natural vapor rub from Sukham Handmade in case he has cold, a natural mosquito repellent cream which is also from Sukham Handmade. All of these are in glass bottles.
For our son, the food that he eats is the same food that we eat, and we have been very conscious about using organic produce, whether it's dry grocery or whether it's fruits and vegetables. We don't give him any packaged food at all. He really has never had any pre-made mixes or anything like that. From the beginning, he has eaten what we have eaten. It's exactly the same. So we try and give him a lot of fresh fruits and vegetables and, you know, things like that. So these were some of my tips. I hope you found them useful. There's a lot that we can do, but let's start from whatever we can. Kids are really smart. Kids don't mind any of these things, and this is all for their future. Thank you so much.